Hello, and welcome to the first video in the series Machine Learning Foundations. We will first learn about the foundational concepts like what is machine learning, how it differs from traditional programming, etc., and work our way up to more complex machine learning algorithms. We will deep dive into the inner workings in the way that we are going to do this by recreating the algorithms themselves from scratch in code, including all the math and all that, so when you do this, you will be able to have a truly complete understanding of how these algorithms work, which is going to help you down the line. There are no prerequisites for this series, but you must have some programming experience with Python. I'd recommend watching some Python tutorials by Sendex or Corey Schaeffer after this video, and you will be good to go when we start coding the algorithms. I hope you are excited and ready to go. Let's start this series by discussing about what the machine learning actually is. So first of all, let's think a little bit about programming and how it looks from a very high level. Perhaps you are looking through stock price data to find an undervalued stock to invest in. One of the metrics you would look at is the stock's profit to book ratio. So you write this code and use it whenever you want to check the PB ratio of a stock. But please think in terms of the three things that I have labeled here. There is data and there are rules that you'll write that act on the data. And that's where we programmers bring value, because those rules then provide answers. So I like to use those terms to summarize traditional programming like this. You have rules and data that come in, and you have answers that come out. The ongoing machine learning revolution from a programmer's perspective is just a reorientation of this diagram. So instead of us as programmers trying to figure out the rules that give us the answers, what if we could feed in lots of answers along with the data and let a machine figure out what those rules are? And that's really what machine learning is all about. Get lots of data, know what the answers are to that data, and then establish the rules that will match one to the other. Now, this may seem a little vague right now, so let's look at an example. We are given a set of dog and cat images. The task is to build a model to predict the category of an animal, dog or cat. We can easily tell that the left one is a cat image and the right one is a dog image. We are able to classify either of these animals because as human beings, we have learned to differentiate between them. Remember all the picture books that you have learned from. After years of learning what dogs and cats look like, with experience we have come to recognize one or the other. Now imagine replicating this process onto a computer through the traditional programming approach. I tried to do so, and this is how it looked like. I checked if the image has whiskers or pointy ears, then it's a cat, or else it's a dog. Also, dogs generally have their tongue out, so you might as well throw that into the code here. The logic seems to check out, but this program is obviously not robust. How do we look for whiskers, or how do we look for pointy ears? It's easy for us to do, but how do we instruct a computer to scan for these features? Also, there could be images of dogs with whiskers or pointy ears. So this would not work. It's nearly impossible to create a program that can identify cats from unfamiliar photos with reasonable accuracy. And even if it were possible to list all these implicit features, teaching a computer to recognize features in cats would probably require thousands of lines of code. With a machine learning approach, the same thing can be done in less than 50 lines of code with an accuracy of more than 95%. Isn't that cool? Machine learning algorithms are capable of detecting complex implicit patterns that would otherwise go unnoticed during human analysis. And this is what makes them so good at what they do. If you have lots and lots of images of different cats and dogs, what if you then looked at that data and had a way to figure out how to match the patterns to the label? You would have a scenario that says this is what a cat looks like and this is what a dog looks like. And that's really the core of machine learning. Having lots of data, having labels for that data, and then programming a computer to figure out what the distinguishing parts of the data are that fit to the labels. And we will learn all these techniques in the upcoming videos. You have probably heard that the inspiration for machine learning or artificial intelligence comes from how the human brain works. And this is very true. Our brain interprets the information gathered by our sensory organs such as our eyes and ears and generates a series of actions for us to perform in response. I mentioned two very high-level features in this example, whiskers and pointy ears, but there could be many more implicit features that our brain processes outside our conscious awareness in order to identify this image as a cat or a dog. Before we write a neural network that classifies whether an image is of cat or a dog, let's see a much simpler example. Take a look at these numbers. There is a pattern that connects them. There is a relationship between the X and Y that holds for each XY pairing. So when X is minus 1, Y is minus 3. And when X is 1, Y is 1, etc. Can you see what the pattern is? I'll give you a moment to think about it. Did you get it yet? Well, let's look back at the numbers. The relationship here is that every Y is 2 times the corresponding X minus 1. If you have got the answer, well, how did you get it? Pause here and comment down. For me, I saw that Y increased by 2 when X is increased by 1. So I guess that it was Y equals 2X plus or minus something. Then I took a guess that it might be minus 1 because when X is 0, the answer was minus 1. I looked back at all of the other numbers and I found out that the relationship worked. That's almost exactly how a machine learning algorithm does it too. In essence, machine learning is pure math. Any and every machine learning algorithm is built around a mathematical function that can be modified. This also means that the learning process in machine learning is also based on mathematics. We'll talk about how they work mathematically and computationally. I will try to discuss all of the relationships between different methods in order to gain as much as depth and understanding as possible. The understanding that I believe will inform good practice so that we are not proving theorems about methods just for the sake of curiosity. We will have theory, but the theory will be chosen because I believe it informs good practice, provides insights and intuition, and that's how this series of videos will work. So subscribe to the channel so you don't miss them. Now, once the model is done training, you can predict values using it. So given what we learned about X and Y and that the relationship between them was Y equals 2X minus 1, what do you think the answer to predicting X equals 8 will be? You might have thought that it would be 15 and you will be very close to being right. But it won't be exactly 15 for a few reasons. Most notably, the fact that the model is only trained on 6 points of data. And that for those 6 points of data, the relationship is linear. That is Y equals 2X minus 1. But there is no guarantee that would be the case for other points. The data could skew off in other directions and our model has no idea if that's the case or not. Because it's only been trained on these limited data. That being said, the probability that it is a straight line is very high. So the model factors that into its learning and when asked to predict, it will give you a number very close to 15. Because the probability is very high that the value for Y when X is 10 is 15. It is an important lesson to remember. Machine learning models deal in probability. They will give you a likelihood that an answer is correct and then you will often have to deal with processing that likelihood. In machine learning, such problems are also known as curve fitting problems because if you plot all of the XY pairs on a graph, and find the line that best fits the data, the equation of the line defines your model and you can begin predicting values using that function. Now if we go back to traditional programming for a second, you might write a function like this. Get answer x to return 2x minus 1 and it would work. but it would only ever return 2x minus 1 because it's hard-coded to do so. You could generalize the function like this, where you pass in the parameters 2 and minus 1, and now the function will return 2x minus 1, and if you want to use other values, you could do so. A machine learning algorithm sort of works like this, where it has the parameters instead of hard-coded values, but it learns those parameters from the data over time. As a result, it's a general function that learns how to behave. And this is what leads to the term machine learning. Our machine learning algorithms are learning the parameters that will give the desired results, with a view to those results then working in the future with other data. If we want to learn things, we could also ask, how do we learn? And how should a computer be taught to learn? Well, for us as a human, there are a couple possibilities. There is this old style way of doing it, right? Memorize facts. Memorize as many facts as you can and hope that your interviewer will ask you instances of those facts rather than other facts that you haven't memorized. This is an example of declarative knowledge or statements of truth. Memorize as many as you can. Better way to learn is to be able to infer, to deduce new information from the old. And if you think about it, this is closer to what we call imperative knowledge, that is methods for deducing new information. So again, I want to drive home this point. In the first case, we built that into the program when we wrote it to return 2x minus 1. However, what we would want in a learning algorithm is for it to be much more like the generalization idea. We want to expand our capabilities so that we can write programs that can infer useful information from implicit patterns in data. So not something explicitly built like the weight of the cat or the dog, but actually implicit patterns in the data, and have the algorithm figure out what those patterns are and use those to generate a program that you can use to infer new data about objects, whatever it is you are trying to do. If you ask me who uses these machine learning algorithms and what applications they have, I'm not sure if you have been living under a rock or something. We have all probably dealt with AI at some point in our lives. When we watch movies, listen to music, or shop online, AI recommends things we might like. AI can convert spoken language to text and translate it into other languages. Artificial intelligence is a critical component of robotics. AI allows self-driving vehicles to recognize and react to their surroundings. Artificial intelligence is becoming increasingly important in medicine. It aids doctors in disease diagnosis. In addition, an increasing number of patients use AI-based apps for initial diagnosis. In the educational sector, AI aids in the personalization of learning activities, such as on digital learning platforms. Such rapid adoption across diverse industries demonstrates the value that machine learning and by extension data science creates, and experts predict a bright future for its application. Artificial intelligence is becoming increasingly important. Once we understand how AI works, we will be able to better assess where it can assist in our daily activities at home and at work, and where we would rather make our own decisions. Another topic I wanted to cover in this video is the challenges that today's machine learning algorithms face. But I won't. Because this is your first video and I want you to be excited about the potential of AI, so why did I even discuss about it? True, I want you to be excited, but also be aware that this is still a field in research and that not everything you hear or see can be deployed into the real world right now. I'll make a video at the end of this series to go over these challenges in depth, because I believe you'll have a better understanding of data and models by then, and thus I believe that'll be a better time to discuss it. Of course, the potential is enormous, but there is still a long way to go, and I hope we can walk through it together. Leave a comment with your favorite AI application. Please leave any questions, comments, or concerns in the comments. Thank you for your time. Have a wonderful day. I'll see you in the next video.